Racing to the 2024 Kentucky Derby, just 13 days away now, and it's time for the often imitated, never duplicated Derby Top 8 as we get ready, just 12 days away now from the Kentucky Derby 2024. We're going to go over the top contenders, my top 8, the Elite 8 for the next 10 days that we're going to be focusing in on as we continue to narrow down the contenders by speed, pace, class, and form. Latest news on Sunday, they announced Deterministic is out of the Kentucky Derby. Grand Mo the First is in. Still the field to be determined in the next couple of weeks. Now, as I've been handicapping these races, and if you're just joining along, this year we have a top-heavy Derby field. Every year, the Derby field is a little bit different. This year, I feel like we've got four really strong favorites. We've got four other horses that are kind of intriguing from an exacta and win standpoint. We've got about four or five horses that I think really just overall do not have good recent form. They do not have good speed figures, and I just think they're kind of overmatched in this spot. They haven't been winning races. So I think the focus this year for me is going to be on the top contenders and how we narrow them down over the next few days. I think, you know, when I look at handicapping the Kentucky Derby, my top factors that I weigh the most, everybody kind of has different handicapping factors. I look at current form, then I look at their running styles. I look at speed because I need horses that are fast enough to compete. And a lot of years, the fastest horse coming into the race doesn't win the race, but they were at least fast enough to be in the top five, six, seven contenders most years. And then I look at pedigree. I do think pedigree is important. Horses do have a better chance of getting that 10 furlongs in top class company with strong pedigrees. So I'll also be looking at the final works and gallops here in the next few weeks. Let's take a look at my Elite 8, led off by Sierra Leone. If you're just joining us, he is 3-for-4 lifetime. He's a two-time stakes winner. Look at him here as look at Sierra Leone. Shiny coat, galloping strong, big muscles. He's got a long stride. Sierra Leone, definitely a top contender. Now, Forever Young ships in from the UAE Derby. He's a Japan-bred and based Mr. Yahagi the trainer. What I like about him is that he seems to kind of run his own race. He's got enough speed to be in the top half of the field early. He doesn't like kickback, but Forever Young did arrive to Churchill Downs early this year and seems to have the right mind for the Kentucky Derby. Catching Freedom, another contender. He won the Louisiana Derby. He is a stretch runner, but he also has enough speed to lay close to the pace. He can work out a trip. Flavian Pratt, the jockey, who is in the prime of his career, Catching Freedom by Constitution, also a nice pedigree. Fierceness, the most likely favorite. He's got a 100-plus buyer as a two-year-old and a three-year-old, cycling back into form, good works, a blowout win in the Florida Derby, and shipping up to Kentucky later on this week from Florida. Another contender, I think, is Stronghold. I like his lifetime record. He's got a win at Churchill Downs. He's got a fast recent workout, and he won the Sunland Derby and the Santa Anita Derby. They seem to be training him to come off the pace, a versatile running style, and I think he's a horse getting good at the right time where some of these other horses are kind of tailing off, like Door Knock. Now, another contender for me is Resilience. I like his move going into the turn of the Wood Memorial. He passed horses quickly. He's by Into Mischief. Again, five workouts in the last five, 6 weeks, getting better. Belmont slowly bringing him along. He's got a race at Churchill Downs. He's faced some good horses in all of his career races. Resilience comes out of that Risen Star race as well. Just a touch, he's only got three lifetime starts. I'm not a big fan of that. He never raced as a two-year-old, but he does got tactical speed. He's got a good speed figure on the time form scale in the Bluegrass Stakes. He was the runner-up to the winner, Sierra Leone. He's got tactical speed, trained by Brad Cox, good sire and Justify. He's a big, robust horse that covers a lot of ground. I think he's not as likely as maybe Sierra Leone or Catching Freedom or Fierceness, but I think he's a good horse. Then a surprise, Track Phantom. I just like his tactical speed. I think he'll be forwardly placed. Trainer Steve Asmussen kind of getting him into shape latest workouts. He seems to be holding his coat, and I like the way he's been galloping over that Churchill surface, and maybe they'll put blinkers on and take him a little bit off the pace. So those are my top eight contenders. Sierra Leone, he is a closer. He's got to save some ground, or is he going to go wide into the stretch like he's done in his recent races? The top Brisnet Speed figures, again, not only the fastest horses, you need horses that can compete. Fierceness with the 112, he towers over the field, but these are on the Brisnet scale. Other speed figures have Sierra Leone with the fastest speed figure. We'll be taking a look at those later on this week. Resilience with the 104, Society Man with a 102. Now, I think that Wood Memorial speed figure on the Brisnet scale is a little bit too high, so I'm gonna give Resilience maybe like a 101, and Society Man, I think, is getting good, but I just don't think he's in the top contenders. Sierra Leone, Mystic Dan got a good speed figure, but that was in the sloppy track. So maybe if the track comes up sloppy, you can move Mystic Dan. Remember, we still need to see the post positions, the weather. We need to see the final gallops. Catching Freedom with a 100 in the Louisiana Derby. That was coming from dead last on the Brisnet speed scale. Now, the projected odds for these top eight horses: Fierceness at 3-1, Forever Young 7-1, Sierra Leone at 7-2, Catching Freedom 9-1. These could change a little bit as we get closer to the Derby, just a touch, right around 13-1. Stronghold, I think, will be a little bit of a price, and then Resilience and Track Phantom going to be some long shots to watch in the Kentucky Derby. Now, overall, you know, this race is kind of unusual. The top two favorites, we've got the Thunder and Lightning Derby, the speed from Fierceness. You've got the closer in Sierra Leone. And which one of those styles, you know, I think the top two favorites definitely are going to be running near. You got Fierceness, strong recent workouts, Sierra Leone in good form. They've got good form. They've got class. To beat those two horses, you're going to have to try to maybe surprise them with a little bit different running style, or we'll see how the post positions work out. Post positions will be drawn next Saturday, April 27th. We're gonna have a full detail of all 20 horses and the post positions when they are released. The Derby Pedigree Show on April 29th, and Jessica Tugwell gonna join us. We're gonna go over all the contenders. She's gonna talk about microdiagonal DNA, also the female families, her top contenders. She writes for Hawkstone Bloodstock and does pedigree analysis for owners. Don't forget, we've got the top speed figures, the running style videos out, the historical prep analysis, and if you want the Derby tip sheet, just sign up below. We'll be having a Kentucky Derby, Preakness, and Belmont tip sheet of all the races those days. It's free, and sign up below. Now, those are my top eight. I want you to give me your top four contenders. Remember, if you're liking these videos, smash that like button. Leave a comment on your top contenders and why you like them. And remember, Dwayne Lucas always says, people have opinions, horses have the facts.